My name is Thorsten von Overgaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world taking photographs and teaching photography. Today, I will just give you a quick brief on my new online video class on photographers' workflow. So normally when you see me, you very often see me talking about Leica cameras and Leica lenses. And it's because simply I like the simplicity of this camera, I like the high quality, and I like that it's just a tool for me to record whatever I want to record the way I want to see it or the way I see it. And also a Leica, you drop a Leica on the floor, you pick it up and keep shooting. I like stuff like that, so no surprise. I also have my own idea how a workflow should be for a photographer. And you could say in anything I do, it's about how do I want to do it. I kind of attack everything in the way that I'm going to figure out how to do this. So I've done that with workflow. I've done possible all the errors you can do in the last 15 years. Taking photos, editing them, archiving them, can't find them or can't find them or whatever. Anything you can make of possible errors, I've done, and based on that, I've made a system that is my system that works in the future. And that's what I will go over. A lot of people have done my workshop or have done my survival kit on either Lightroom or Capture One Pro, so they know a lot of the thinking. This format is a little bit different because now we've seen everybody been going online and live on Instagram and Zoom and everything. And it's kind of like, yeah, that's cool, but it's actually not that cool to sit and talk to a camera. It's much more cool to deal with real people. So I said, okay, I'm going to do this format where I'm going to do a weekly class on workflow. And it's going to be interactive. We're not going to be live, but it's going to be interactive. So I have a plan of things I want to go over. And then the ones who participate in this, which is basically, when I'm done with this, this is going to be a product that anybody can buy and download and watch. But those who sign up and are part of making it, they get to get questions answered and so on. And I can give an idea, some of the things I'm going to go over is some very basic things. What is an archive? And your photography archive shouldn't be what Apple tells you to do or what Lightroom tells you to do. No, your archive should be independent. We're so lucky we have had libraries for thousands of years and we had photography archives for hundreds of years, so we can learn from that. But it's essentially, there's going to be a lot of work in this workshop. I'm not going to do it. The only one going to do the work. You can, and that's why we spread it over maybe 8, 12 weeks. What do I know? So there's going to be a lot of stuff that's going to inspire you to, okay, how you should you do this? And you might have a lot of stuff lying around that you should reorganize. That's also part of the workflow or the workshop. So I can tell, we're going to talk about archive. And let me just give an example. An archive could be, I don't collect stamps, but if I had to be a stamp collector, I would have to figure out how do I organize my stamps? Do they go by year, by country, by value? How do you organize stamps and how do you do it in a way so you don't have to reorganize every time you get a new stamp? And that's a little bit the same problem you have with a photo archive and with any other type of archive, but there is ways to organize archives and it's not to connect with a software that basically takes your pictures and do it for you. You have to make your own archive. And if you have photographed for 1 year or 10 years or 20 years, you already know that this is a problem. But it's something that we can solve and that's what we're going to do together. Then we get into, well, of course, how to organize an archive and do it on the fly. So that means you take photos. And one of the things, the important things is that the product of being organized is freedom. So even you're an artist doesn't mean you have to be disorganized. On the contrary, you should be very organized because the more organized you are, the more you can create new things and not fumble around and try to see what you, where did I put my pictures or did I lose them or what happened. Then we'll get into how to keyword old pictures. We'll get into how to salvage an archive that is a mess. We'll get into how to organize things that was before we started having a system or a different system. And I will come in with, because I have, we'll talk about hard drives, but here I have my hard drives, I have 60 terabyte of pictures right here. And recently I had a picture that went worldwide. Luckily, Associated Press had it in the archives, so when people wanted it, they just picked it from there. So I thought, oh, I should go look in my archive and look for this picture. So I find it, but in the process of finding it, I also find other pictures that, like, wow. And one of the things, for example, I found two rolls of black and white photos that were scanned of a tour I did with Juliette Lewis. I never seen those pictures before, but maybe I have, but I forgot it because it's like 10 years ago or something. So you stumble into a folder like that, which has lots of subfolders, and you think, oh, what do I do with this? And that's something we get into. So that's kind of the fundamental things of having an archive, and that's very important in the way that it gives you the freedom, it makes you very organized, it means that you can find things when you want to find it. So if your son or your spouse or your friend or somebody or yourself think, where is this picture? You can find it in like 10 seconds, and that's how it should be, and there is a way to do that. It doesn't have to be easy to get there, or you could say like, no, it can be actually very easy. You just have to think about it before you get into something. And you could say you should stay away from anything where you can buy easy solutions. You have to make your own solution. You could say the workshop, I have planned here like 15, 16 episodes. That's already 4 months. That's kind of crazy. The way it's gonna go is it's gonna be a little bit like my workshop, that we just go out with a camera and then we have an idea what direction we're going, but maybe we think, oh, it could be fun to go in there in that building for 10 minutes or 2 hours, and then we do that. So the workshop here is gonna be a little bit the same, that if you think, wow, that could be interesting to explore this area, then we'll dive into that. So that's the whole idea with the format, that I'm not sitting here and talking to you, entertaining you for 12 hours, but we're having some sort of dialogue and about what problems do we have, what do we want to accomplish with this, and what is the different viewpoints. And of course, there's also ideas like, what about iPad, what about the cloud, what about this? And then we get into, you could say, what you actually thought you would get into, which is how to edit photographs, how to edit colors, how to edit black and whites, how to crop them, how to keywords, how to export them, and where to put them, how to back them up, how to prepare them for print, how to prepare them for online or social media, how to prepare them for email, websites, everything like that. And I can say that all my pictures are edited, they're ready for print, they're ready for social media, they're ready for newspapers, for everything. I don't have to touch those pictures again once I'm done with them. And I have this, that I don't spend a lot of time on a computer, but I have this system that is very organized, and when I'm done with it, I'm done with it. It's ready for any use. So that's part of the goal that we want to get there, that it becomes a really well-organized archive. And you can say, if you have a big mess, it's great, you really need this. If you don't have a big mess and you just have just almost started taking photographs, you also need it. And one of the great things is that I will also take questions. I don't know how we're going to do it yet. Maybe we do a Zoom. If we do a Zoom with the group of people helping with this workshop, that one won't be part of the final class, just because you cannot record a Zoom and put it into a video. So that's going to be exclusive for us. But I will answer questions, and I already have a couple of them here. So for example, here I have, this is like the Tonight Show, but it's not a joke. So this is a professional photographer, and he said, I already have all my professional work organized by event dates and job numbers, just like like you do, that's me. But then of course he also takes personal photographs. And he can't really figure out, how should I do that? So far I did it in years and months. But then sometimes you just take maybe 3 good photos in a week that is personal, like of your family or something that you think is interesting. So what do you do with them? And he asks, what do I do? Well, what I do is that I sort of know that if I get an assignment or something, and even if it ends up being just 5 photos, it will be a separate job, so I can find it again. It's not mixed up, and also I can finish it. It's not mixed up with everything else. But I also have actually an ongoing month of photographs, so anything I take, like I took a walk last night, I took some photos, I throw them into the computer. But the main thing is, what I do is when I import them, is that I edit them. So every time I have imported some photos, before I leave the computer again, I'm done with those photos. Because if I don't do that, then I will import photos and import photos and import photos, and I will go through them once in a while because I need this photo now and, oh, this looks good. But the problem is, if you collect a whole month like that, then you're gonna work it over 5, 6, 8 times, and sometimes you don't finish it till like 5 months or 12 months later. So one of the key things is to finish things once you touch it. So if you can't finish everything the photos you import, don't import them, just wait. If you want to do it in that. But the great thing is, you could say that it aligns with what I have on my website. I have a monthly story, what happened this month, no matter where I was in the world and what I did. I'll take some of the fun photos or good photos and just put on that side as part of that story. And that mainly comes from that, and of course assignments also, but it mainly comes from that monthly chunk of photos that I just take and edit as I go. It can be very messy if you don't organize in the way that you actually handle work when you get it. Let's just take one more question just for the fun of it, because I have it. And somebody says this, would you ever consider teaching on using Apple Photo app for those of us that use it? And that is actually going to be part of this workshop, is how do you organize Apple Photos or any other system in a way so it can work for you. And I can already say now, one of the problems with Apple is that it is often cloud-based and it's based on a software. And if Apple changes that software, and they already did a few times, then you lose your whole way of you organize it, or maybe you lose things if they're not written into your files, and maybe you don't even have the files because they're in the cloud. And that's, then we're back again to the beginning, and that's why I kind of organized it in steps, is that no, you need to build your archive. You're not feeding a software. And if you should compare it to anything, you could say, well, I could have all my laundry and dry cleaning over the dry cleaner, so I would just go over and they would have store everything. I'll just go over and pick up what I need for the next few days, and then I'm fine. I don't have to store anything myself, it's always ready. But what if the dry cleaner closes or burns or something like that? I don't have any more clothes. So that's a little bit the same you have for the cloud. Like, why would you have it somewhere else when you can have it yourself? And it's much more safe to have it yourself. And but that's stuff we will get into. I mean, this could be a 2-hour episode, how just to deal with Apple Photos, because it's not that easy. It's connected with the cloud and the iPhone. Anyway, if you haven't fallen asleep yet, this is what this class is going to be about. And it's like the first time I do a format like this. I think I'm actually going to do more things like that on portrait photography and everything else. But now we start with workflow, which is probably the most, one of the most boring things you can deal with. I'll try to make it not just as long, but also as almost exciting as Game of Thrones. I'll try, I won't promise I succeed, but that's the idea. Go, there's a link below the video. Besides that, you can get a free ebook and you can sign up for my mailing list and do a free online workshop or masterclass. You can also find a link to a little bit more about this class, and you can sign up for it and be one of the ones that gets to work on this. That's all I had to say today. Till I see you next time, remember, always wear a camera.